Hi, and welcome to part one of making a CMoy headphone amp for the Eclipse Mints 10. The 10 is this one here, and it comes in different colors. It is much smaller than your average Altoids 10. This here is your average Altoids 10 that many of you overseas would be familiar with. And this is the common Eclipse 10, which is readily available here in Australia. So, as you could see, it is much smaller compared to the Altoids. This project has taken me a very long time due to various setbacks. Here is a voltage multiplier that I had done last year. I'll be using only these parts here, of which, well, back then it was used for something else plus the CMoy. And having done it on a breadboard recently, I discovered a little error. So here is the updated version. Basically, the TC962 multiplier times 2. So you've got one multiplier and then the inverter, and then you have the positive and negative voltage regulators to keep the voltage at a steady Now, this here is the original version, which is the multiplier, the voltage regulator, and the inverter. Now, as far as batteries go, this is your average, your normal 9 volt battery. As you can see, it can fit nicely into an Eclipse 10, but for my liking, I like rechargeables, and there are 9 volt rechargeables. But to make my life easier, I wanted more space in the Altoid, in the Eclipse 10. Now, there is someone on the internet in Australia that makes a circuit for that, but because I don't know how to do very nice and neat boards, this is a common vero board or strip board. As you can see, it's called strip board because the copper tracks are in strips and the holes are at 0.1 of an inch apart. Now, what I'll be doing is I have two options for the Eclipse 10. Option number one, use AAA batteries, two of them. So, being lithium ion, these are nickel metal hydrate. So, lithium ions are 3.6, 3.7 volt on average, and their range is from approximately 3 volts to 4.2 volts when they're fully charged. And you can also use lithium iron polymer, which are 3.2 volts on average, and get charged at 3.6 and can go down to 2 volts. Now, these are the CR123 or LR123. These are, as you can see, rechargeable batteries. These do not have the protection circuit in them, but what I do like about them is that they are supposedly, as you can see here, 1800 milliamps at 3.6 volts. So, two of these can fit end to end without the holder, of course, inside, just need some heat shrink tubing, and the same goes for these AAA batteries, of which, as you can see, can fit fairly nicely. And if you put them in a shrink wrap, you can more easier pull them in and pull them back out, put them in and pull them out, and that will fit nicely with this here, which is a standard PCB strip board that you can buy off the internet. So as you can see, battery number one and battery number two, and you still have space in there, and it does not impact on the switches. Now, as you can see, these two batteries in series provide 8.12 volts. The same would apply for the two triple. Now, here comes the test for the voltages. As you can see, on one side it's just 7.27, for argument's sake 7.3, sorry, and for the other one it's at 8 volts, or just above 8 volts, 8.04. So that's from the voltage regulator, the other is from the inverter part. That's why I needed to update the design so it can be the same on both sides.